Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, today we will see characteristics of photoelectric effect. Now we know what is photoelectric effect. When the light of suitable frequency incident on the metal surface, then there is an emission of photon. This effect is called as photoelectric effect and emitted photon called as photoelectrons. Let us see what are the characteristics. Now, this is the arrangement of photoelectric effect. It consists of evacuated glass bulb and two metal plates. There is one window so that light can incident through the window. Initially, we will keep metal plate A at negative potential and plate B is at positive potential. And we'll see first point, that is variation of photoelectric current with potential difference. Now, at this point, keeping intensity constant. Or we can write here, at constant intensity. Now, when we start this experiment, we have observed at zero potential, there is a very small amount of current. This current because of high kinetic energy of the electron. Even if the potential of metal plate B is zero, but still when electron move from the surface, it acquire a very high velocity. And that's why some of the electron will collide on metal plate B and current move through the circuit. That's why even if at zero potential, we have a very small amount of current. Now, we are increasing the positive potential of metal plate B. Now, when we increase the positive potential of metal plate B, there will be the more attraction. So, electron will attract towards metal plate B. Just say intensity is constant. Means initially, we will say there are 100 photon incident on the metal plate A. And for ideal condition, we will consider there is an emission of 100 electron because one photon will get absorbed by one electron. Ideally, this is not possible. Let us consider there are maximum number of 100 electron. Now, when the positive potential of metal plate B is less, that case, out of these 100 photoelectrons, only 10 electron will incident on metal plate B. And we have a current because of 10 electrons. Just say like this. Now, further increase the potential of metal plate B. Then instead of 10, we have current because of 30 electrons. Means there is a more attraction towards metal plate B. Hence, we have a current because of 30 electron. Then again further increase in positive potential of metal plate B. Say we have current because of 70 electron. Means more number of electron now attract towards the metal plate B. So in this way, current can increase up to the 100 electron. Then, like this, but after a certain point, even if whatever be the positive potential value of metal plate B, there is no increasing the current. So, because there are no more electron available. That's why this current become constant and this value is called as saturated current. This is just an example to understand the concept. But practically, we will get current because of a very few electron. This is only the example to understand the concept. Actually, there is only 1% of electron, that is photoelectron, gives a photoelectric current. Remaining energy is dissipated as a heat. So, this is only to understand the concept. So, here we have saturated current. And this type of thing we are getting when metal plate B is at positive potential. Now consider metal plate B is at negative potential. Now variation of photoelectric current with potential difference. But now metal plate B is at negative potential. So this is the arrangement. This is positive potential, current I, zero, and this is negative potential. So here we know even if at zero potential, we have a very small value of the current. And for positive potential of metal plate B, we have this type of graph. But metal plate B is at negative potential, means we are not interested in this part. We will focus the negative potential part. So at zero potential, there is a very small amount of current because of high kinetic energy of the electron. Now, we'll keep metal plate B is at negative potential. Emitted electron is having negative charge. The same time, we have metal plate B is also having a negative charge. So there is a repulsion between negative, negative, and number of electron will decrease. So when we have less negative potential, so just say initially we have current because of the 10 electron when potential is at zero. Now we are increasing negative potential of metal plate B, means there is a more repulsion. So out of 10, 2 electron will go back because of the repulsion and will get current because of 8 electron, means there is a decrease in value of the current. Then further increasing negative potential of metal plate B, we will say 6 electron will repel from metal plate B and we will have current because of only 4 electron. Again, there is a decrease in value of the current. In this way, we are increasing the negative potential of metal plate B and we are reaching at one point where there is no emission of the photoelectron, or there is no single electron will reach up to metal plate B, means current at that point is zero. So that negative potential value is called as a stopping potential. So stopping potential, it is a negative value of potential for which there is no photoelectric current flows through the circuit. Now next characteristics we will see, that is effect of intensity on photoelectric current. Now here this is a positive potential. Here we have a negative potential, 0, and current I. We know even if at 0 potential, there is a very small value of the current. And when we increase the positive potential, then the current also increasing up to certain limit and then it is making constant. So this is called as saturated current. Say this is intensity I1. And here we have stopping potential. This is V0 stopping potential. Now take the intensity more. When we say more intensity, means more number of photon will incident on metal plate A and there is a more number of photoelectron. So in that case, we have more current, that is more photoelectric current. So we have here more photoelectric current and its value increases with the potential and then again it will become constant for intensity I2. But what about the stopping potential? Stopping potential is the property of the metal plate. So here stopping potential value will remain constant because we are not changing metal plate, we are just changing the intensity of the light. Let us consider third intensity, which is greater than I1 and I2. So again there is an increase in the value of the current, but still there is the stopping potential value will remain same. So in this way, photoelectric current changes according to the intensity of incident light. Now we will see third characteristics, that is stopping potential and kinetic energy. We know stopping potential is a negative value of potential for which there is a no emission of the photoelectron. When we are saying there is a no emission of photoelectron, means it works against the kinetic energy. So we can write here kinetic energy, that is maximum kinetic energy, is equal to EV0. Here V0 is a stopping potential, that is maximum kinetic energy is equal to E minus work function. So here we can write maximum kinetic energy, that is H nu minus H nu naught, which is equal to maximum kinetic energy, and this kinetic energy we can write like EV0. Hence here we have H mu minus mu naught, and here we can write H C by lambda minus C by lambda naught. Hence, we can take it common like HC 1 by lambda minus 1 by lambda mu naught, which is equal to EV naught. Hence, stopping potential V naught is equal to HC by E 1 upon lambda minus 1 upon lambda naught. Here, we know lambda naught is related to the work function, because we know work function is nothing but HC by lambda naught, means that is related to the work function. And lambda is the wavelength of incident light, means our stopping potential is depends on energy of incident light and work function. And we know work function is a property of metal. So we'll write here work function of metal. So our stopping potential, it depends on energy and work function of the metal, but it does not depend on intensity of light. Means in previous characteristic we have seen intensity is changing, but the stopping potential value is remain constant. Means stopping potential is not depends on the intensity of incident light. So these are the basic characteristics of photoelectric effect. Thanks for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and please subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.